The Philippine Senate aims to pass 10 measures to strengthen the economy next month. These measures include proposed amendments to the Retail Trade Liberalization Act, Foreign Investments Act, and Public Services Act. Majority Leader Senator Miguel Zubiri adds the Senate has also pledged to approve the proposed creation of the Department of Overseas Filipino Workers in August or September.
Philippine economic managers are sticking to their 6-7% growth target for 2021, despite continuing lockdowns in the country. The Development Budget Coordination Committee, or DBCC, says it reaffirmed this year's goal due to the declining number of COVID-19 cases in the country from its peak in April, and as the economy gradually reopened. For 2022, the DBCC expects the Philippine economy to grow 7-9%. It also sees the economy returning to pre-pandemic levels as early as 2022 if the Philippines manages to keep the health crisis under control. The Philippine economy suffered its worst contraction on record last year, shrinking 9.6% as government imposed one of the longest lockdowns in the world. A Tokyo court sentences two Americans to more than a year in prison for their role in helping former Nissan boss Carlos Ghosn skip bail and flee Japan. Details in this report.
A Tokyo court on Monday handed out the first sentences related to Carlos Ghosn's arrest and escape from Japan. The former chairman of Nissan was smuggled out of Japan in late 2019, hidden in a box aboard a private jet. U.S. Army Special Forces veteran Michael Taylor was sentenced to 2 years, while his son was given 1 year and 8 months. Both pleaded guilty last month to helping Ghosn flee to Lebanon, where he remains a fugitive. Prosecutors said the Taylors received $1.3 million for their services and another $500,000 for legal fees. Ghosn faces charges he understated his compensation in Nissan's financial statement by $85 million over a decade. He's also accused of enriching himself at his employer's expense through payments to car dealerships in the Middle East. Ghosn denies the charges, and Lebanon does not have an extradition treaty with Japan. Last month, he said he would only go back to Japan to clear his name if the legal system, where the conviction rate is 99%, was changed.